Oh, hello. Welcome to Studio Classroom on the Air. Your English will improve today. My name is Gabe. You know, I was on a flight once from one city in India to another city, and I was talking with a passenger next to me, and the topic of trash came up because the streets of a lot of cities of India are lined with trash. And I said, it's kind of unfortunate that there's so much trash. And he said, yeah, but think of it this way. It's kind of part of the culture. But friends, I disagree. I don't think that trash should ever be part of anybody's culture. The name of today's lesson is Zero Waste, Full Recycle. A zero waste lifestyle is one where you try to create no waste or trash. It doesn't sound possible, does it? I mean, you have to throw your trash away somewhere, but it is a good idea or a goal to have, and of course, it's only possible if we commit to doing things like reducing our use of things or reusing things that we have or perhaps recycling some of those things. That's known as circular economy. Okay, more on that later. I need to pick the rest of this up, and we need to get started.
Zero waste, full recycle. One man's trash is another man's treasure. Jacques-Yves Cousteau, the French explorer, once pointed out, population growth is the primary source of environmental damage. As the world's population continues to increase, so does the amount of global waste people produce. According to data collected by the World Bank Group, nations are on pace to generate 4 billion tons of waste annually by the year 2100. Many experts are calling the growing problem of global waste a worldwide health crisis. The reason being that pollution from trash is not only wrecking the world's oceans, air, and soil, but also endangering people's health as well as the livelihood of all living creatures.
Hey, Gabe, what's that smell?
Rebecca, what do you mean, what's that smell?
I smell like trash or something?
No, you smell trash?
Yeah.
Okay, I think I know what it is.
What?
I was picking up trash earlier, and so I think maybe, I don't know, maybe my clothes smell like trash now.
You probably spilled something on you and didn't wash your clothes.
Maybe. I washed my hands, but, you know, that just happens sometimes when you're out doing community service, like a good person, good, decent citizen. Mm-hmm. Then sometimes you might smell like trash afterwards.
Well, make sure when you go home, wash your clothes, okay?
Yeah, thank you. That's a good reminder. I will. Anyway, I wanted to say thank you, Michelle, and let's get right into our lesson, Zero Waste, Full Recycle. All right, the idea is right there in the title, the idea of having no waste at all. Rebecca, do you think that's possible?
To have no waste?
Yeah.
Well, I definitely think that it's possibly possible.
Possibly.
Or at least to reduce the amount of waste that we have. Mm-hmm. If people would be more careful about recycling and doing other things to cut down on the waste.
All right. Well, think about that, friends. We see here a phrase, one man's trash is another man's treasure. I guess we'll take a look more at that idea further in our lesson. But before we do that, basically that's the idea that for some people it might be trash, but for other people, maybe they're really looking for something and it's really valuable to them.
For example, let's say that you have a friend who is throwing away an old shirt. They just don't want the shirt anymore because maybe they don't like the color and they bought a new shirt. And you see that shirt and you're like, wait, don't throw it away. One man's trash is another man's treasure. I want that shirt.
Funny you should use that as an example because that's exactly what happened when I left my previous house with my roommates. Angus was throwing a shirt away and it looked really cool. So I just took it from him. Hmm. One man's trash is another man's treasure. Okay. We read here about a famous person, Jacques-Yves Cousteau. The French explorer once pointed out, population growth is the primary source of environmental damage. Such a negative thing to think about. The idea that making more humans, which is a good thing, is actually just is just damaging the environment.
Oh, that's rather unfortunate. But you know, Gabe, I really do like that phrase, to point out. What does the phrase to point something out mean?
Oh, right, of course. This means to bring something to somebody's attention or to make people notice something that perhaps they hadn't noticed before.
For example, let's say that Sammy was getting ready to walk out the door to go to a nice dinner, when all of a sudden her sister stopped her and said, Sammy, you have some cat fur on your shirt. She nicely pointed out that there was some cat fur on the shirt.
That's right. She pointed it out. Let's jump down two sentences. According to the data collected by the World Bank Group, nations are on pace to generate 4 million tons of waste annually by the year 2100. That phrase, on pace, means that we're heading steadily in a certain direction.
For example, Mandy is on pace to graduate next May. If everything goes as planned, she'll definitely graduate.
And that's a positive example. It's great to graduate. It's not great to produce 4 billion tons of waste in less than 100 years. Okay, let's jump down another sentence. The reason being pollution is that being pollution from trash is not only wrecking the world's oceans, air, and soil, but also endangering people's health as well as the livelihood of all living creatures, okay? So this is a terrible thing, and I really hope that it doesn't happen. We have to do something about this.
Well, that's exactly what our lesson is encouraging people to do. Do something. We'll learn more about that later, but right now it's time for us to learn something new in the InfoCloud.
Welcome to InfoCloud. There are many figures from the Bible that are well known to almost all native English speakers, even if they themselves aren't Christian.
If we say something is a story of David versus Goliath, everyone knows that there is a weak person going up against someone incredibly strong.
Or if someone betrays another person, they might be called a Judas, the name of the person who betrayed Jesus.
But there's one strange English expression that uses two biblical figures, robbing Peter to pay Paul.
This expression means to take from one to give to another. The phrase usually indicates you are paying off one debt by taking on another.
For example, if I owe one friend money and then take a loan from a family member to pay off my friend, I am robbing Peter to pay Paul.
This phrase is incredibly old and dates all the way back to the 1300s. Peter and Paul were both apostles and are key figures in Christian history.
One of the reasons this phrase works so well is because you have alliteration, as both Peter and Paul start with the letter P.
Welcome back to Studio Classroom. I hope that you are in a good mood because we just learned the unfortunate fact that it's predicted by the year 2100 that we will be throwing away 4 billion tons of waste annually. And that, of course, is affecting our earth, our oceans, the air, the livelihood of all living creatures. What can we do? Reduce, reuse, and recycle.
Zero waste, full recycle. Reduce, reuse, recycle. Such a dilemma raises the question, is there a more responsible way of dealing with people's refuse? Fortunately, there is. For years, government agencies have been telling citizens that living a zero waste lifestyle is the way to go. One example of this is what's often called the three R's: reduce, reuse, recycle. Reducing the use of plastic containers, as well as reusing and recycling bottles and cans, decreases the amount of garbage being sent to landfills. As a result, less money is spent on waste management, and countries' financial burdens are significantly relieved. Such positive effects on an economy, as a result of applying the basic rules of reduce, reuse, and recycle, is known as a circular economy.
Okay, let's look at this section, reduce, reuse, and recycle. So we have a dilemma. The world's oceans, our air, the land, everything is being polluted, and people are the main problem, okay? So such a dilemma raises the question, is there a more responsible way of dealing with people's refuse? Now, let's take a look at that phrase at the beginning of this sentence. To raise the question, this is a good phrase for you to know. Something raises the question. This means that it makes you ask the question. There's a problem or a situation, and it makes you think of a question.
Exactly. For example, a few years ago, I was down in Kaohsiung with a friend, and we were riding on a scooter together going up this hill, and all of a sudden, we saw all of these wild dogs. There was probably at least 50 wild dogs. And just seeing all of those wild dogs raised the question, is there something that we should do about all of these dogs?
That would have raised the question for me, where's the owner? Is there an owner for all these dogs? Are they someone's pets? Or are they just wild dogs?
Well, they were just wild dogs.
That's crazy.
It was crazy. I had never seen so many wild dogs in one specific place. Even the girl that I was riding with was a little nervous about it.
Yeah, that's a little bit scary. Okay, well, that's a great example. Friends, think of another situation that made you think of a question. Use that phrase, it raised the question. Just a quick note at the end of that sentence, of course, the word refuse as a verb to refuse somebody, but here it's a noun and it's pronounced refuse, someone's trash.
Aha, that's right. Moving on. Fortunately, there is. For years, government agencies have been telling citizens that living a zero-waste lifestyle is the way to go, the way to do something. One example of this is what's often called, the three R's, reduce, reuse, recycle.
And we quickly see what that means. Reducing the use of plastic containers as well as reusing and recycling bottles and cans decreases the amount of garbage being sent to landfills. As a result, less money is spent on waste management and countries' financial burdens are significantly relieved. Okay, so it'll be easier for countries, especially in regards to their financial burdens. A lot of countries, probably most countries, are in debt in some way. Well, that's a financial burden. They have to pay their debts off. But a financial burden in general is some kind of money that you need to pay, and it's a negative thing. It feels like it's weighing you down.
That's right. For example, after Jamie lost her job, she didn't really want to move in with her parents because she didn't want to be a financial burden to them.
That's very interesting and practical example. A lot of people feel that way. I don't want to be a financial burden to you. Okay, well, you see this picture here. It's the contrast between linear economy, which we'll learn more about tomorrow, and circular economy, and that phrase appears at the end of our lesson today. A circular economy is, of course, when you are reducing, reusing, recycling, and able to use some of those things that you perhaps originally would have just thrown away and gone to the landfill.
That's right. Well, right now it's time for the SC Challenge. Hey, everyone. Welcome to the SC Challenge. Yes, I know that you're all excited, and so am I. Well, let's meet today's contestants. They are very excited.
That's right. Hi, friends. I'm Pauline. My husband challenged me to a rematch, so I accepted.
Hello, everyone. This is Josh. And one thing I love about my wife is that she's always up for the challenge of trying to beat me.
Well, let's see who's going to win today. Pauline won last time, but you never know. Josh might win this time. Okay, are you guys ready?
Ready.
Bells are ready. Let's get to our first question. According to research done by the World Bank Group, how much waste is expected by the year 2,100, so 2,100. A, 4 billion tons. B, 4,000 tons. C, 400 tons. Or D, 4 tons. Yes, Josh?
I'm going to go with the biggest number possible. A, 4 billion tons.
A, 4 billion tons. Mm. That is correct. Good job. 1 point for Josh. Well, next question. Number two. Trash destroys the environment. We know that, right? Which of the following is an example of something impacted by trash, but is not discussed in the lesson? A, the ocean. B, the air. C, animals. Or D, soil. Yes, Pauline?
Soil.
Soil. D, soil. That's a good guess, but actually that's not correct. Yes?
I'm going to go B, the air.
B, the air. No, that's not correct. Yes, Pauline.
The ocean?
The ocean. No, that's not correct. What is the correct answer? Yes.
Animals.
Animals. Yes, animals are impacted by trash, but it's actually not discussed in the lesson. So 2 points for Josh. Last question. Which of the following is not one of the three R's? A, reuse. B, reduce. C, replay. Or D, recycle. Yes, Pauline.
I know this one. Replay.
C, replay. That is correct. You both did a great job. But Josh does have 2 points, so he is today's winner. Well, friends, thank you so much for joining us, and I'm sure you answered all the questions correctly. We will see you next time.
Well, it is always good to face challenges. And hey, you know, I don't know if you've had a chance to yet, but in your magazine, there's a page called Reader's Toolkit. It's a chance for you to practice some of those usage tips from this month and a lot of the key words. And some of it I wrote myself, but that's not important. Anyway, today we learned about the importance of reducing, reusing, and recycling. That's called circular economy. We're going to learn more about circular economy next time right here on Studio Classroom.